Praise God. For Satan shall not be, he will not succeed. He will not. He hates these videos. He has confounded me with the Word of God to such an extent that I deleted everything. But the Lord is stronger. And praise our Father Yahweh. For he has opened my eyes so that his word can be filled into your hearts. What a battle. What a battle with this entire likeness and representation image thing. Lord Jesus. The enemy doesn't want me to record videos and put them on the internet because it damages his image. So let us all communicate with videos. Hallelujah. Bear with me. The Lord has given us a way to live on earth without the government. The Lord has given us His kingdom and His authority and His word as the perfect kingdom. The kingdom is now in our spirit. We shall all die physically, but spiritually we either live forever or we don't. We either choose God or choose the world. So we must choose God's calling, and we must minister to each other the word of Christ as Christ reveals it to us, and through my brothers and through many ways the Lord has shown me the right path, and it's his word. His word is the right path, and we are very confused by his word because of modern theology and religions and translations, but we need to go back to the first century writings and get ourselves the Greek manuscripts and study and see how clear and simple the Word of God is to man. And it's so wonderful. It's very simple, it's very calm, very quiet, very loving, caring. It's very free. True freedom starts in spirit and in truth, because only God is truth. So do not fret and do not worry about government pressing you, for Christ has conquered it. You just need to open up to Christ, let his heart be for him, and let his law be written in your heart so that you could live in the kingdom of the heavens now. And that way, no tax and no Caesar and no court and no officer on earth will ever injure you. God's word is our shield and sword. So, let us praise God in this moment and let us enjoy his victory. Let us enjoy his victory. For he has succeeded in conquering death and sin and sins and debts of any kind. Numbers are fiction on computers. They don't exist. You're the money. You're the reality. Your energy is what's money. So, let us make the separation. Let us sanctify ourselves to God and live in his kingdom and be with him right now. Hallelujah. Let us go in person. Well, let us go in presence to these so-called authorities and speak the word of God to them. Let us, if Maybe we should let them come to us. You see, it all depends on your goal. Is your goal for yourself or for God? If it's for yourself, then I guess you'll do what you will, right? But if it's for God, then what does He have to say about it in His scripture? Think about it. All the things we do that are away from the scriptures, things we do for ourselves, things that we think are for God, but are they in Christ? That's the question. Am I in Christ? Am I doing this in Christ? Am I doing this in the kingdom? Am I doing this beholding the smiling face of my Lord in my spirit? That's the question. And so, as the entire day passed, I battled and prayed. And here it is, the success of Christ again. Oh, Lord Jesus, praise Father Yahweh. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We love you, our Master. Peace be with you.